trying to see me. Best believe they ain't breathing, they was 6 feet deep.
Wake 'em up.
It's not over. Nah, it's not over.
Wake 'em up.
Tell your grandma. Tell your moms.
It's not over. Hey. I'm alive and I woke up looking fly. That's my shit. That's my shit. You can call me Lazarus. You can call me Lazarus. From a dead man. I'm missing it. And they can't find a body. Well, we started up at a party. And you can tell it any way you like. We was all raised by the Christ. Green mile. It's been cleaned out. And tell them I'm alive, bro. God connected to me. Yeah. Wake 'em up. Wake 'em up. It's not a game. Good morning. Help me on it. That's my shit. That's my shit. You can call me. I'm a dead man walking. And this has been my theme music for years. And y'all know I just be playing this music so I can set up this live stream on another device so I can see how they doing it, because as y'all been seeing, I guess they trying to deter me, but anytime I do a live stream here on Fuckbook, they keep fucking with the videos and everything. But I'm gonna do more videos where y'all can see shit straight out, and I'm definitely for all them damn Zendaya lovers. Oh, y'all know I'm finna do that over, right? In slow motion, so y'all can watch that gay man walk around and prance around and every damn thing, so y'all can see him. In the meantime, we're going to talk about this dude right here. But let me get my shit together back here so that we can come back. I did not even know that he did the a halftime. This motherfucker about 100 with these big-ass implants and shit. Okay, we gonna get to it. We gonna get to it. All right. Let me get my shit together back here. They play too much with these dudes. Hubert. Okay.
Hey, bitch, let it drop right here.
You better tell me if you with me. Trying to stop me, got these people out here wishing they could pop me. If they won't be coming, get me. Man, I ain't scared of none of y'all. The only thing I fear, the IRS and God. If you want me, go against me. Nah, they probably better think twice. Got aims over my head, war on my mind. If you want me, come and get me. Well, yeah, I might as well go ahead. I'm probably more of a threat to y'all when I'm dead, though. Huh. 24 years old, my mama brought me to the globe. She tried to tell me.
What up, Karen, Michelle, Beth? Hey, glad y'all here.
My education, but remember there's a bias.
And the rest of y'all, glad y'all here. Love y'all.
told me God ain't
finna piss people off. That's what I get. And it, tell them do it. If you with me, I know the devil's trying to stop me. Wish a nigga pop me. Come and get me. I ain't scared of none of y'all. And if you wanna go against me, got an angel over my head, warm my mind. I'm probably more of a threat when I'm dead, though. Yeah, when I drop this meat sack.
God opened up my mind, and he showed me I don't have to be a product equal by.
With this God-given wisdom, I can
climb out the hole, stay about the system, cause the system
never lets you go. Speak the truth without no fear, it can ruin.
I've been a mascot too long, I ain't come here for no cheers.
First of all,
let me be clear one time, let me be real one time.
If you want a religious, you gon' have to
hang this guy. I've been around the world, seen pretty girls get beat up like sex slaves. Crooked cops done pull me over, treating me like I ain't made.
In the image of God, and that's so odd. We'll snap back. Gon' hate. You better tell me.
Hey. I know the devil trying to stop me. Got these people out here wishing they could pop me.
If you want
me, come and get me.
And I ain't scared of none of y'all.
The only thing I feel, I IRS and God.
Not them. To me, it's a limitation.
Interplanetary on my navigation. You can follow me to every destination. Come on, let me make it plain. Look,
I'm
trying to fly.
What?
Let me tell it, man. Look,
I ain't never lied to you.
I'ma keep it real. I'ma ride with you. Get the key and peel. If you're getting money like a key to wheel, don't fill it back.
Gonna make a meal. If you're hating on me, then you speak something.
If you're faking on me, go let us know.
I got plans later.
Look, I've been trying to tell them since 04-05.
Real talk.
Still, you know these people doubt me every time.
Fuck them.
Had an alter ego, but my ego altered at the altar call. Looked up at the ceiling and I heard an angel talking, y'all. What they say.
I was made in this image, in its likeness.
Fight this if you don't like this.
Herbs and spices, righteous.
Nothing in the world can like this. Hold on to it with a tight fist. Prototype this. No matter what your type is.
You better tell me if you're with me.
I know the devil trying to stop me. Got these people out here wishing they could pop me.
If you
want me, come and get me.
Hey.
And I ain't scared of none of y'all. The only thing I fear, the IRS and God.
If you want to go against me.
Nah, they probably better think twice.
God ain't drove my head, warm my mind.
Come and get me,
fuckers.
Well, go ahead. I'm probably more of a catchy eye when I'm dead, though.
Ow. They dropped that beat so we can rock with it for a minute. Hold up. All right. So, I had this up because, you know, sometimes I pull up shit. When I go in and check and see what the fuck is going on here in Devildom and what they're giving us for news and entertainment. Because news to me is entertainment. It's just another program. So, I had this up, but then I found out that it was a Super Bowl. I don't pay attention to the fucking holidays or sports events or none of that shit. So, I was like, I want to go live anyway and talk to the people about something else. And then when I had this up here and I looked and it was saying that Dolly Parton did a damn halftime show. Like I said, I don't pay attention to that. That shit, none of the shit they do here in Devildom gets my attention or excite me or I give a fuck about. So I don't know. But I thought, isn't that ironic? Because ain't no fucking coincidences. But isn't it ironic that I was thinking about Dolly Parton, who I think looked like Hubert from The Family Guy. Now, I was going to go back and look at this motherfucker. And at the same time, this one here did a damn halftime show. We're going to discuss that one too. We're going to go through that one and look at that one. But I had this video because they're talking about a person to person. And I'm like, is they really going to talk to this person? This one here hiding up under the wig? The man? So I didn't know. So I just was like, let's see. That's like too much.
Dolly Parton is the queen of country music.
I found out it was a double drag. That when they say queen, anything they name in Queen, First Lady, all that shit, is usually a dude in a wig like Dolly. And for all you motherfuckers that's getting mad with me because y'all don't see or know or understand what the fuck a transgender is and what an implant and makeup is and can't see this dude, you want to be mad at me? Go ahead, be mad. I gives no fucks. Anyway, back in truth and in reality, it's like, what the fuck is they talking about with this man right here? So, let's check it out.
A one-name wonder, Dolly has sold over 100 million.
Ooh, look at the lump right there in the throat.
Charts in both country and pop music. With more than 5 decades in the spotlight, she's done it all. Hit songs like Jolene.
That motherfucker sang that song right there about the damn vaccine. Vaccine, vaccine, vaccine. I wanted to choke him. But anyway, y'all love him. I hope this one didn't trick you into getting the damn shot. Vaccine. Okay, I can't stand him. Okay, let me be quiet. Go ahead, go ahead, go ahead. They got a whole show.
And coat of many colors. To classic movies like 9 to 5.
An accident. She was thinking about doing it.
First of all, I don't want y'all to act like I was immune. You know, I'm from South Carolina. I'm a country girl. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of these stars right here, I love them. I love them. I thought they was wonderful. They sounded great and every damn thing. And, you know, I was just like, y'all, I was caught up in their shit. Now I look at him like, this is another motherfucking howler. He howling, hypnotizing us with the howl and the wig and the makeup and the damn implants. And we love him. But, you know, now at 53, it's a dude. It's a double damn drag. It's one of them. It's against us. It's out to deceive. That's where I'm at. I'm trying to bring you there. And if you ain't there yet, it's okay. It's okay. Because like I said, back in the day, I loved these motherfuckers too. Okay? I like singing too. But we sing. They howl. All right.
On it last night.
Plus a Broadway musical, countless books, and a theme park near her hometown called Dollywood. Never forgotten her humble roots, the Tennessee native was born
look
in
at
a
him.
One-room cabin in the Smoky Mountains, one of 12 children. And at 77, the blonde bombshell isn't even close to done.
Bombshell?
She's coming out with her 49th studio album.
Oh, God.
This one, a rock album, appropriately named Rockstar. She's also giving a close-up look at her incredible
Hold on, y'all saw the I'm talking to my siblings, the ones that can see shit. You see this motherfucker put the star right on the eye, right there in on the eye. Okay, I'm talking to my siblings with see shit. You know what I'm saying? For the rest of y'all don't see shit, take note of that shit and then look it up and find out what the fuck we talking about. But for my siblings, y'all see the star right on the eye? This nigga like, fuck y'all. That's how come I'm like I am. Fuck y'all. This dude done put the star on his eye with his wig and makeup. All right.
Clothing and costumes over the decades in a new book, Behind the Scenes, My Life in Rhinestones. So we went to Nashville and sat down with Dolly for an intimate.
Oh my goodness. Y'all know I'm in Tennessee. That's where I'm at now. And when I came to this motherfucker and I started looking around, I'm like, this is a little mini devildom. I mean, like, they is here. They got their shit here. They come here. They got fucking hotels. They put down carpet for these motherfuckers here. I'm right here, right with these damn devils. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, damn. Should I say something? And then I'm like, yeah, I have to. And I talk about all they shit, but Lil Nashville, move over to New York. Lil Nashville, home of the country howling abominations. All right.
Person to person conversation. Dolly, it is so wonderful to meet you.
Well, I feel like I know you, but thank you. Same to you.
First of all, wait a minute.
Thank you. So how did this project behind the scenes come to be?
Well, it's called Behind the...
First of all, when I look at him, I'm kind of like horrified. I'm like on the verge of witch, warlock, demon looking thing. It's horrifying, it's hideous. Now, for those that are not familiar with transgenders, wigs, makeup, implants and shit, and jawlines and anatomy, then just look at him right there. From my other device, I see that fuck look have blurred that up a little bit, but I'm on pause over here where I'm at in this situation, but look at the jawline. I'm going to bring it over here. Look at this shit right here, okay? And the whole shape of the head. And what the fuck is this going on right here with the eyebrow? It's like the skin is not matching with the body and what they're trying to do. And because they gave this motherfucker titties, dudes, y'all went blind. Because they gave this one implants, some silicone, stretch the chest out and put some fucking silicone in there. Y'all forgot to look at this jawline, this big ass fucking head right here. These hands. It's a dude. But now, in the day of, let's kill everybody that didn't take the shot. My enemy is necessary. Let's fuck up the ones that's out there so we can get them to take the shot. We gonna throw this dude up here because your grandmama love this dude. So maybe your grandmother love for this dude will trifle down and trickle down to you and fuck you up. I'm here for you though, babies. I'm here to tell you the truth. This is a big ass dude right here. Whatever the fuck this one howling, fuck him. And whatever the fuck he promoting. Okay, let's go. Okay.
On the seams. It's all about my life in rhinestones and all about the clothes.
It's retarded.
Over 6 decades. Going back from when my mom used to make clothes for me all the way up through to when neighbors used to make clothes and different people in Nashville all the way up through Hollywood and some of the finest designers and hairstyles as
lip
well.
Drop.
And so that was a clever little title that my niece Rebecca, who's a curator, has helped put it all together.
First of all, I don't feel like going through all of that fucking shit right there with him. I don't. But I just want to let y'all know who this motherfucker remind me of. Is this little motherfucker right here. Every time I see Dolly Parton, I think of Hubert.
It's like girls are a different species or something.
Oh, who needs them? You like popsicles?
Well, sure.
And you need to come on down to the cellar. I got a whole freezer full of popsicles.
No, thanks. I gotta get going.
Oh, don't make me beg now.
You're funny. Bye.
Get your fat ass back here.
Okay. Every time I see fucking Dolly Parton, that's who in the fuck I think of is Herbert. Herbert right there. That's who I think of all the time. I don't know what the fuck y'all see. Every time I look at him, I'm like, look, Herbert in real life. All right, now let's get over here to this fucking Super Bowl halftime show because I didn't see that. I did not. But we gonna watch it together. Okay, here we go.
TNT Stadium, where the tradition of giving only grows stronger.
I don't like how they got all of them up in red like that. That shit right there is demonic looking right there. To me, that's what I see. Y'all got the fucking babies and these little, supposedly girls, but 9 times out of 10, they little boys. But y'all got them all in red. And they all in red and shit. And what the fuck is this red thing back here? Is that a pot? Will y'all throw the kids in? You know what? All this shit looks satanic to me. So that's what the fuck I see. But let's get back to it. Because this devil dragon is representing demonic shit. Starting off with this big ass pot back here and these babies. Alright. Sick folks.
Family have kicked off the Salvation Army's iconic National Red Kettle campaign. And this holiday season, they are joined by a special guest.
No.
Well, happy Thanksgiving.
And like I said, Dolly Parton remind me of Hubert the pervert, always trying to get fucking kids. You know what I'm saying? And then they started off with some fucking kids in the beginning with some red on. Sacrifice colors. Red, black, and white. The kids in red. Already. It's a snow theme. It's white. This bitch come on here with black and red on with the blonde fucking hair. Sacrifice. Kids. Perverts. That's all the fuck I see. I'm just showing y'all how my mind works. Okay.
Army to love beyond the holidays. Now when you drop a dollar in that red kettle, you can make a difference for the family.
Put these bitches in that kettle, because these motherfuckers right here can give out all the money, stop all the homelessness if they get rid of one or two of these fucking extra homes and lands and shit that they got. Not doing shit, but just having it, taking it the fuck away from us humans. They can do something to help us. They not gonna do shit. In the meantime, they're going to keep begging you to drop your fucking dollars in their little kettles and fill up that damn big-ass boiling pot for kids. I don't know what the fuck they're doing. I don't trust them. Fuck. Okay, let me be quiet. Go ahead. Oh, shit. There they go. I did something. I'm sorry, y'all. That's me. Let me go back. I get so fucking agitated with these motherfuckers. I do. This motherfucker want to come up here. We're not going to talk about him. Who the fuck he is. He did something. This motherfucker. That's my next video. It's in the fucking Hall of Fame. I'll be back with that one. I'll be back. In the meantime, I'm sorry. Let me stay focused and get back to this motherfucker right here. Hubert. Let me get back to him. I'm sorry, y'all. My bad. Then they're going to show a commercial and shit. In the meantime, we can watch one the fuck this one talking about right here. Okay. We're going to get back to that.
She came up with that title, and I thought, that is so clever behind the scenes. So in My Life in Rhinestone, so we headed out and did it.
It's been pre-ordered by many people.
Yeah. Well, listen, it's a coffee table book, and it's really got laughable things in it. I look at the wigs and some of the clothes I've worn, and I laugh out loud.
Of course he look at them wigs and laugh out loud, because he know he a dude, and he got to put every last one of them damn wigs on so that he can keep tricking y'all. Look at this hideous creature right here. What the fuck is going on right here? What is all this? Where's the eyebrows starting at and shit? This is one that's breaking all the way down. It's melting. It's melting right in the fuck in front of us. The jawline and every damn thing. It looks horrifying. Nobody can see it? Okay. We see you, Dolly, sir.
I tell the stories about where I was and what I was thinking at the time and when I wore it.
I know you say you don't care about fashion. How can that be?
Well, I don't care about following fashion. I've never been one to follow what other people are doing. I see what's going on, but I never could have afforded in those early days. But I just had my own personality, my own thought of who I was and how I wanted to look. I laugh out loud when people say I'm a fashion icon, because I never intended for that to happen. I just kind of dressed the way.
Hold on, I want to stop right there, because they be howling about all this stupid shit, and this one talking about it didn't like the wigs and stuff. Stop. All of them love wigs. That's what they have. They love wigs and implants and fucking makeup and fucking injections and surgeries and shit to make them appear to be what the fuck they are not, like this dude right here that y'all been loving, because they've been howling since y'all been... It was howling since I was a baby. I'm 50 fucking 3, okay? I grew up with this one right here howling. I used to love him, okay? I used to love him. Love the voice. Oh, it was talented and this, that, and the other and everything. And, oh, they just looking at him wrong and all this type of stuff. But this is a big-ass dude with fucking implants. And this just wasn't the fuck it is. It's a dude with implants. And I think it's Hubert from The Family Guy. I think that's what they did. But I got this back up. Yeah, I got this back up. Oh, my God. I got this back up. So let's get back to this one here. and Fuckbook is going to fuck with my video. But we gonna keep going. We back. Hold on. Hold on. Let me back up, cause they doing a lot of howling. We can't see shit. What's happening? Hold on.
And for the single parent,
okay, here we go.
Grief this month. Show all your right. Neighbors in need love beyond the holidays by finding a red kettle or giving online at SalvationArmyUSA.org.
Nope.
And now the tradition continues. Here to kick off the annual Red Kettle campaign, please welcome global superstar and rock star, Dolly Parton. Hold on. Fuckbook has blurred it. I'm gonna come back. I'm gonna do this fucking video again, where they not fucking up the view. But this is a whole fucking man. From the implants to these fucked up looking hips. There's implants down there too, I'm looking. And these legs. Look at these fucking legs. And look at the fucking knees. This is a dude all day. I'm not with y'all. I'm going to stop it again. I brought it up a little bit because maybe Fuckbook. But no, I can look from my other device. They keep mangling my video. But don't worry, family. I'm going to do this fucking video again. I'm going to make sure I get it. And I'm going to do it again where we can see. These legs, look at this fucking body, this fucking jawline right here on him. Look at the legs. This is a man leg all day. There's nothing sexy about that. Ain't no way in the fuck a natural woman gonna put on some little shorts and expose their leg and it's not gonna look beautiful, sexy, round, curved, toned, shapely in the way. If you put a fucking boy in Daisy Dukes, he looked like a fucking boy in Daisy Dukes with a wig and the implants and makeup. This right here. A dude cannot play a woman and be more beautiful than a woman. You fuck up. One thing Mag said, you fuck up when you put that dress on a dude. You fuck up when you put any type of female clothing on a man and want to throw him up there in the front of the fucking people. Look at Dolly Parton right here. There's nothing feminine about him. It's a dude in some little shorts representing all the fallen ones with that jawline and that wig. But take away that, look, cut him off at the waist and go down. It's nothing but a straight dude.
Jolene,
we got a lot of 9-to-5ers out there. Am I right? I wrote a song for you. You're going to help me out.
And what I noticed from that little roundup right there is they got a lot of dudes right now in Daisy Shorts. Right now. This motherfucker right here is not the only dude. All they show us is dudes. Okay?
Let's go. Well, I tumbled out of bed and I stumbled in the kitchen. Pour myself a cup of ambition. Yawn and stretch and try to come to life. I jump in the shower and the blood starts pumping. Out on the streets, the traffic starts jumping. With folks like me on the job. From 9 to 5, everybody, you can 9 to 5. What a way to make a living.
It's nothing they can put on this old man right here. Oh my goodness. Can we go back right there? Right there. Look at the leg on him right there. Look at him right there. That is nothing but an old man in a fucking stockings. Hubert. It's Hubert. Oh God. And I'm gonna stop it right here because they're doing too much spinning. They won't let my shit play. I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna do this fucking video right here again with Hubert over here. But I'm gonna end it with, look at the legs on this motherfucker right here. Look at the legs. Those are man. It's nothing feminine or sexy or feminine about this dude and his legs. Okay? Nothing. Either a great tuck job or a eunuch. We don't know what the fuck going on, but those is implants. This big ass head and this wig and this makeup, this is a dude. Okay? They don't show you nothing but dudes on all the halftime shows. Every motherfucking female they put on the halftime show been a dude. Down to this sad version right here. I don't know what in the fuck going on. Guess because it lived past them nanobots. It got a superpower. If it took it, then so they gonna give it a show. But fuck him. Okay? Fuck him taking the shot. Vaccine. Fuck him. It's a dude. That's all I want to leave you with. It's a big ass man. Look at these damn legs. Look at him. Any man, if you a leg man and you love women's legs, then I know you throwing up right now when you look at these legs right here. Okay? Stop. You ain't fucking blind. Ain't nothing wrong with you. It's a dude in the wig. Fuck these motherfuckers. And I'm out. Good night. And I love y'all. And I'll be back. You know I will.